بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم دكتور علسيوف بدياتك نورولوجيست امريكان بورد we will continue our series of abnormal movement in infancy or children today we are going to talk about stereotypical behavior that happen in infancy stereotypical behavior what do I mean by that what I mean by stereotypy or stereotypical behavior is abnormal movement or abnormal behavior that the infant or kids keep doing again and again as a pattern. For example, one of the stereotypical behavior that we see in infants, you know, they tend to shake their feet like this when they get excited a lot of the time, and they shake their feet like this in a stereotypical manner. When they are excited, sometimes they tend to look from the side of their eyes or look to the side in a habit-like manner or in a stereotypical-like manner. And this sometimes they tend also to bang their head on a soft thing, or when you put them on the couch, they tend to bang their head against the couch. So it is a movement that the kid or the infant does in a habitual manner without any associated signs or symptoms that might be suggestive of seizure or epilepsy. And again, what are these signs and symptoms that might be associated or suggestive of epilepsy or seizure that differentiate the seizure attack from the stereotypical behavior or stereotypical movement? One, altered mental status or loss of consciousness, unresponsiveness, drooling, feeling the kid is not right during this attack, locked jaw, post-ictal state where the kid tend to sleep after these attacks, and while the attack happen or is happening, the patient does not look right. This is, you know, the overall sign and symptom that I might help you to differentiate seizure from the stereotypical behavior. Of course, the attack itself is very important. If I have a kid who has sustained right upper extremity fisting and tonic posture like this one, even if the patient is responsive, that could be a simple partial seizure, okay? And it's different than something the kid would do, like, you know, shaking the legs during excitement or head banging or looking from the side while he is completely responsive and interactive during this attack. Now, the reason I talked about this stereotypical behavior, because this is a big concern for them family. We get a lot of consultation about these conditions, and the family sometimes get into a vicious cycle where they end up doing an EEG, and the EEG read, you know, normal or abnormal, and it could diagnose a seizure, and they go into this vicious cycle, while these abnormal typical behavior should be diagnosed mainly by the history and by seeing the movement. This is why I tell the family, please, if you have abnormal movement, or if you see things that you don't you don't feel good about it, or you are concerned about your son that he might have something, please videotape it. And when you videotape it, just send it to us. This will help us big time to do, you know, the right decision. Stereotypical behavior usually does not need to be investigated beyond history and physical exam. No need to do an EEG, no need to do an MRI. It's just reassurance and observation. Always keep in touch with the patient and tell the patient, keep in touch with me if something changed in the condition or in the movement. Other than this, there's nothing to do other than reassurance and observation. And most of the time, it will disappear with time. Thank you very much and have a